Novak Djokovic penciled in for opening match at Australian Open despite visa cancellation. Novak Djokovic could face the prospect of going from the federal court to the tennis court inside 24 hours after Australian Open organisers surprisingly scheduled first-round matches in the top half of the men's singles draw on Monday. The world number one from Serbia had his visa cancelled for a second time by the Australian government on health and good order grounds yesterday. He was due to be detained by immigration officers in Melbourne overnight before a preliminary procedural hearing for his appeal against the decision. The full hearing, in which Djokovic's participation in the Grand Slam tournament will be determined, will almost certainly be held tomorrow. If the 34-year-old is successful, then there will be little time to prepare for his opening match against his compatriot, Miomir Kecmanovic, ranked number 78, on the Rod Laver Arena the next day. Craig Tiley, the tournament director, declined to instead schedule the bottom half on Monday, perhaps mindful that accusations would inevitably follow of special treatment for Djokovic in the top half. Tiley is already under intense pressure over his role in the confusion surrounding the process of applying for a medical exemption in the absence of a COVID-19 vaccine. Stu Barker is the latest high-profile figure to have expressed disappointment that the seemingly endless controversy has taken the spotlight away from the tournament. "I've had COVID and I know people that have suffered so badly," Barker, the former British number one, said. "The Australian public has had the strictest rules possible. So many of them weren't even allowed to travel, let alone internationally, to visit sick or dying relatives in other parts of Australia. My sympathy has gone now because it's now distracting from the whole tournament. This is a grand slam. We wanted the number one player in the world. He could have been there by being vaccinated. I know he's chosen not to and that is his right, but it is also his choice and with that choice comes consequences, and this is why he is where he is now." Allies of Djokovic, on the other hand, were left infuriated at events over the 10 days since he was first stopped at the border. "Toxic shame on each and everyone involved," Janko Tipsarevic, a former Serbia Davis Cup player, said.